Air Force new F-15EX fighter jet completes environmental acoustic testing. Hello everyone, welcome back to Intermediary channel. Air Force new F-15EX fighter jet completes environmental acoustic testing. A team at Eglin Air Force Base in Florida has completed a two-week series of acoustic tests for the U.S. Air Force's F-15EX Eagle II, a new model of the F-15 bearing GE-129 engines. Eglin's Operational Flight Program Combined Test Force, F-15 section, led the testing activity and contracted Blue Ridge Research and Consulting to capture the sound data, Air Force Materiel Command said Monday. Test administrators aim to establish a baseline of sound data to update the information on noise level predictions and models where the aircraft will be deployed. The F-15EX was subjected to ground-based examinations with the plane in both idle and active modes. The aircraft was also flown at various heights and in various configurations. The effort's objective is to create a baseline noise level for the Department of Defense use in support of an environmental impact study on the aircraft. Over 35 microphones were used for the ground and flight tests of the Eagle. Zachary Arnes, Deputy Mission Support Section Chief of OFPCDF, said the team is one step closer to handing over the aircraft to warfighters. The activity marks the first time that an in-depth digital acoustic sound testing was done on any F-15 model. Ground and flight sound. To capture the sound data, experts from Blue Ridge Research and Consulting placed over 100 microphones strategically around the aircraft. Separately, 45 microphones were spread 4,000 feet 1,200 meters laterally and 1,000 feet 305 feet horizontally across the test field to capture sound from more than 70 Eagle II flyovers. The U.S. Air Force Operational Flight Program Combined Test Force OFPCDF February 15 section coordinated requirements to make the trials possible. As the lead developmental test organization, the OFPCDF enabled DoD to meet their deadlines for the environmental impact study, and we are now one step closer to getting this new aircraft into the hands of the warfighter, Deputy Mission Support Section Chief, First Lieutenant Zachary Arnes explained.